One love.
The two best left-handers on the men's side of things in the sport, going head-to-head here for a spot in the final. This WTT champions Frankfurt, Lin Wenru of Chinese Taipei against China's second seed, Wang Shuqin.
Love, two.
One of the most skillful players in the game, Lin Wenru, right there at the very top with regards to that. Does he have the cement to put all those bricks together against Wang Shuqin, point
one,
by point?
Two.
Wang will be wary of the skills. Lin Wenru's beating him a few times.
Let. One, two.
One of them, of course, that iconic flick. There it is.
Three, one.
Puts extra pressure on the server.
Yeah, it was how he announced himself on the scene. That flick.
Four, one.
He's got to have the right, if you like, the right minerals, the right personalised mental approach here. Because in terms of shots, I'm with you. He's got those to be able to shock Wang. It's not just that, of course, that you need. You need so much more.
One, five.
He tries to flick there and flicks in vain there. And trails by four into the first towel break. No, it's interesting, Lin, looking a bit deeper into that head-to-head, we did reference it at the outset. A couple of things to say. The fact that he's got the wins. Hasn't got a win since towards the end of 2019, Lin. And the last four times that Wang has beaten him,
one, five.
Hasn't lost a game. And they've been pretty straightforward wins
one,
as they go.
Six.
Those four.
Lin had a bit of a purple patch. You think of him as a top 10 player, but obviously just dropping outside of that, trying to prove that he belongs in there, where I feel he does.
One, seven.
Ruffled the feathers of Wang early on here.
Yeah, very early on, but it's at the moment you can see how you set it up that Lin has got the game to trouble the Chinese.
7-2.
Remember, of course, it is best of seven here. The change in format dynamic from how they've been playing through the week. And you can even break down their head-to-head further across those eight meetings. Only two of them played in this format. One each in that respect.
There it is again. We're going to see it throughout. I mean, the way he flicks through the fingers. Incredible. The versatility, the flexibility of that wrist.
Left. Two, eight.
Wang has it as well. We saw him play a beautiful Chiquita. Coming more on the side of the ball.
Three, eight.
There's the physicality, the transfer of weight from his left leg through to his right, using that waist, that strong core, and all that racket speed.
8-4.
Putting it into the middle there, Wang Shuqin, just out of the comfort zone of Lin Wenru's backhand. Always looking, using the peripheral. So many things to have to think about, to have to do, to have to react to.
8-5.
Coming back into things a little bit more now in this opening game one. Enjoyed that one. His lefties not giving an inch.
He muscles it out there, Wang Shuqin. So hard, the attacks, aren't they?
6-8.
making more of a solid contact than what you do with Lin's slightly crispier contact. Wang can just seem to dismiss spin.
The step from Wang was superb, but Lin ends up taking it.
Great switch. Wang did well, but too little too late. Don't think of him as a lobber, do you?
Won very convincingly their previous meeting last month, the men's team semi-final. You lost 16 points there in three games.
10-7.
He's in some trouble here still in this opening game of this one here in Frankfurt. So it's the first of these four game points for Lin.
Feels like Wang is adjusting slightly better.
11-7.
There we go, though.
Another error. And he begins the second.
One,
no. Lin with a couple of WTT contender titles in Almaty and Zagreb. And he's winning through in terms of service success at the moment. A man from Chinese Taipei, 60%. One struggling on serve.
One, all.
Mid 40s. Not used to seeing that.
So fast in and out footwork of Wang Qichen. Definitely the hardest striker of these two. Lin Wenru's always had these silky skills, but has added a bit more physicality to his game, you know, more time in the workroom, in the gym.
Set. One, two.
Block. It's a little bit loose. Tried to change the pace and placement, but Wang eats it up. It's that decisiveness that we come back to.
3-2.
Sometimes it feels like it's going to take a net to get them doubtful, get them hesitant, because of how well they read the game. Team China players.
2-4.
And to fight back here in this second game, and a good start in that bid so far from Wang. Four of the first 6 points here in game two for the Chinese. Seiko Ezeki. With Lin. It's Wang Hao at the other end. One.
2-5.
Qichen, that is, turns towards his coach, the 2009 world champion. Pump of the fist there.
Wow.
5-3.
Look how he rips that one, Lin Wenru. The sweet spot of that backhand. I mean, we talk about the flick, but in the rally, the backhand is also so good. Oh!
5-4.
A cracking counter there from Lin Wenru. There's some oohs and ahs from the crowd. Wang step the corner. Paid the price. What a reaction.
Please play.
All it took was such a short stroke because Wang had put all the power into it.
Five, all.
Yeah, despite opening up that lead, comes back to how you set this match up, I suppose, in terms of engagement. It's so far here, Lin, making Wang a bit uncomfortable. you think one, the last four times that he's beaten Moon, he's done it without dropping a game. And it's not obviously going to be the case here in this meeting. Some of them have been pretty routine over all those victories. Straight games, you know, the scoreline progression.
Seven.
Yeah, I mean, Lin Wenru is a player who's beaten Ma Long. He's beaten Fan Jendong. Beat Haramoto in the last round in their first WTT meeting. This guy's cream of the crop. One of the most studied players. He's got a very difficult playing style to disrupt. But the fact Wang Chichin hadn't lost a game in ages against him shows how good Dato is.
Seven, six.
He's had more than his fair share of fortune. I will say that. A couple of edges and then that net there just to add salt into the wounds. But it's the fact he even gets behind that ball so comfortably in the first place. Lin is an old head on young shoulders in a way himself.
Seven, oh.
So smoothly done, gliding around Lin there to get the better of Wang again. Good lead he had. Wiped out for the moment.
Seven, eight.
And he finds the net, yeah. Gifts his opponent a point there at a key stage. Sort of treatment. He normally dishes it out. Not the first time. We've seen here. Lin sting one like that. Oh, that's a wonderful change, isn't it? Just so well, so stealthy. From one in so many ways.
He might be absorbing the attacks well of the world number two, but he does not want to fall back on that as a safety net too much. Safe isn't the right way to play against a player of Wang Chichin's caliber.
A couple of chances here for one to level up.
Nine, ten.
With a touch received there in the first of them. Stands firm here. We'll take it to tens. First time in this match, then we've gone there. 2 point to a winning margin needed, and the serve now will alternate. So we get that outcome. Remains a really pivotal period of the semi final here.
Oh. 11, 10.
You saw that. It was on it in a flash.
He gauged the line so well, because some players would have acted too prematurely there and stepped in and got caught out by that serve that was intended to surprise. Brilliant receive from Lin Wenru, and he's got game point on the serve.
Yeah, having saved a couple.
11, all.
That was brilliant, that receive, wasn't it? Came into it so quickly and trapped it. Oh, wow.
Please,
levels.
pushed out so 11, far 12. Away out of position. Might be the silent assassin moving around quietly, but he couldn't make the noise there that he needed. Wang Hao there, so passionately responding to that. Oh,
13,
11. Game. At the end, I suppose. Hitting back to level this up at one each.
Love.
So one. Table there. It's funny, you look at the conclusion, Fraser, to game two. You'd say, oh, Lin had his chance there at 11-10, had a game point. And sometimes you actually just got to give credit to the opponent. It's not that he's failed to take his chance. It's just Wang Qiuqin was able literally to edge through on his final game point.
It's one. Easy to think oh. about what could have been, but I mean, that touch from Wang at 10-9 was exquisite. I mean, the composure and the execution there. It's 1-1. And he's got to reset. Lin should try and build upon that encouragement that he got so close.
One, two.
More than a match. Again, for the former world number one. Away from the table in the open rally.
They covered the net down the line there, Lin Wenru. So much
one,
arc
two.
On that top spin. Out of position, it's really, really good to play with slow spin. Deep on the table, if possible. Oh, my word.
Oh, warming up nicely, isn't it, this? Bubbling up the hot pot of this one. So much spice about this contest. So much shot quality.
2-0.
Can't help but rub your hands together here at some of the points that we're seeing. Flawless technique. I mean, technique, some coaches really think it's about what looks good, but it's about what's effective. Just happens to look this good as well.
3-0.
We've lost six of the previous eight. And there is a point back for Lin there. This is the point earlier. It's an amazing point so far that we've been in those open rallies. They're both grappling for supremacy in that respect, that element of the matchup, and indeed in most other aspects of it at the moment. Nothing separating them in the score.
3-4.
It's just so tough to tell. Who has the more uphill battle in this match? Lin Edge is in front, though.
Oh, just that one before the change, just a subtle change of direction from Lin. Probably proved down there to the difference there in the end. And it was another tight, compelling rally.
Strong flick from Wang Qiuqin, creating the cave there. Lin is trying to serve with no spin. Not easy to flick a serve with no spin with a lot of quality, but Wang Qiuqin there, nice and relaxed in the hand and the wrist.
5-4.
And the mind to make that possible.
Play. 5-0.
Feels like Wang might sometimes be baiting the flick to then try and go against the momentum of Lin Wenru, who is trying to protect that backhand side after it.
filed.
Across the body with a seatbelt shot there down the line. It's insane how good these two are.
I mean, for this match so far, that's just standard. Nothing out of the ordinary.
Oh.
6-4.
Well, it's a walking highlight reel, this match at the moment. I'll have one. And then you will too.
Look at the face of Wang Chuqin.
To nothing that one could do about it. Came out in the lights there, catching that back edge.
Great body language though from Wang Chuqin. It's done. On to what he needs to do next.
Net. 6-7.
Lin's supporters, Lin himself, a little bit disappointed for the net there because that had worked like a dream, that change up. Have to go again.
8-6.
Doesn't make it obvious what he's going to do there, Wang Chuqin, and goes down the line.
8-6, please play.
Crafty in the short game, sent that one long. But when he's near the net, I'd say underrated, Wang Chuqin.
He's got such a
superb touch, hasn't he, as well? Numbers both well down here. That's the quality of the matchup, though. Quality of the receive and the pressure being put on.
6-10.
Wang is handling the pressure of this third game a little better than his opponent. Really isn't much in it though.
11-6.
It is though.
Game for Wang.
Third game for Wang in the end.
One love.
So the fourth game beginning here in Frankfurt. Lin Wenru, he went a game clear. Now 2-1 down to the second seed, former world number one, Wang Chuqin.
Love, two.
That's the first couple of points there to the man who's got this on-running battle, hasn't he, at the top of the rankings with his compatriot Fan Zhendong at the moment.
Love, two.
That battle ongoing to be king of the hill.
Love, three.
Really struggling, Lin, to calibrate his flick as easily as he normally can. And that's courtesy of the placement of Wang's serve and receive. Wow.
I mean, how good was that
Three,
from Lin? Improvisation. That one there, whoa.
And kept it so tight, that for me is the most skillful Three, shot of one. The day we've seen so far.
Agreed.
In what you would think to be the completely wrong place to even do it. Unreal.
3-2.
Wang's facial reactions have been interesting. He's embraced the fact that he's actually met his match in terms of quality on the ball. And the sweet spot, the area of where a player can play a shot from.
3-2.
It's what's making the rally so long. Despite the power coming in off each racket.
3-all.
Yeah, the big question's going to be, I think you're right with the body language, because he's seen so many amazing hot shots that have been too hot for him to handle in this. But again, the question over the best of seven format, that mentally he'll back himself to ride the storm. The tricky moments, I mean, that last couple of games have been that. And four, Lin had game point in the second. The third was tight for a while, and one mentally, as much as anything, went on and took the lead here. And he'll back himself over that best of seven, despite, in terms of shot quality, as you say, meeting his match.
3-5.
Although an amazing streak here from Lin.
Yeah. To see it like this as well, talk about his mental strength, the fact he's in front, but as you've explained, Fraser, here, in terms of the general matchup, this is a bit, still a bit of a pick'em at the moment on that on that basis.
It is, and one there kind of pointing to his head and saying, look, I need to reset. Sometimes when you know you and your opponent are such a similar level, you kind of loosen up too much. Kind of thinking to yourself, all right, we might as well just go straight to a one-set shootout, but can't afford to risk that.
6-5.
Can't afford to allow that to happen, because then it really is anyone's. When you add all that additional pressure to the mix.
6-5. Time out.
Lin resuming with the service.
6-0.
Cat and mouse table tennis. Ebbed and flowed the scoreboard here. Slowed the pace right down there, Wang Qichen. Comes up the ball more without transferring too much energy forwards.
Yeah, you're saying cat and mouse. It's difficult to know who's the cat and who's the mouse in this one.
Six,
and,
seven.
Wang in front, but I'd say they're two big cats here. Jostling here, taking each other on still for supremacy.
Play, please.
Two big cats in the WTT jungle.
Yeah.
8-6.
Although Wang Qichen gives me more kind of lion vibes. They call him Lionheart. Lin feels more of a kind of panther.
Silent assassin, I like that.
Blends into the night. Seamless in his transitions.
7-9.
I was listening to you there, perhaps.
Such a, basically an impossible ball to counter that. Look at it, just skidded along the surface.
Yeah, purring effort from the panther.
Backhand.
Oh my.
That's ridiculous. What did he apologize here for? That is unbelievable feeling. The sexiest shot of the day.
11-7-10.
And purrs of approval from this Infinity Arena crowd as well, Ali. It's given him game points.
11,
and he takes
seven.
Them. That's a spurt, isn't it? Level again with Wang Qichen.
One.
Does fast long there to surprise the Chinese, first of all. It was semi-finals in Xinjiang earlier this season. Lost to Liang Jingkun in that one. 4-2.
After beating Ma Long.
Love two.
There's two titles as well. For Lin, that is. They've come against the Chinese opponent, Shan Peng. Those victories, Wang, of course, quite a few levels even up from that, but shown, as you say, can beat members of the Chinese national team.
Love three.
And Wang has always been, you talked about the body language here, is known really from that opening game that he's met his match on this day in terms of shot quality. What we're getting here, I think, from the moment from Lin is real belief. The mental minerals, if you like, that are so fundamental as well. And look at this start here to the fifth.
But every single bit of optimism is guarded for good reason.
Love.
I think that's a fantastic point you make, because players can get ahead against members of the Chinese national team and you feel like they go off the boil or they start celebrating. And Lin isn't doing that here, despite winning the last 8 points. There's no grandstanding, showboating around.
He's
very unlucky
five.
There, of course. It's just all business. As it should be.
Yeah. As it has to be, you know. The Chinese are the best at finding that wiggle room. You find yourself in a healthy lead, fantastic. However, expect an increase in quality, expect a change in pace, placement, rhythm. Wow, Wang Chi-Chin.
Oh, we've had some points this week in Frankfurt. That could be the finest of the lot from the Silent Assassin.
He has absolutely creamed that down the line.
Oh, he's making some noise here.
Without a word said.
Let. 1-6.
That was jaw-dropping, wasn't it? And then a sizzling seven, Chiquita.
Oh.
Coming right around the side. There's no topspin on it at all.
I'm saying it now here. We put a highlight reel together. Forget the rest of the matches here today. Just this alone.
Yeah. 7-2.
It's good enough on its own.
You're forgetting we've got Felix Le Brun versus Ma Longai.
Oh, we've had ones already, but I just think...
Look, yeah, I mean, I know.
And we're only in the fifth.
I know. It's been an absolute treat.
It's been three... There's 3-4 minutes here already.
Yeah.
The highlight reel. And they're going to put on some more as well. I mean, who is making the decision on what to put in that edit? Good luck with that.
Might have to change it to a top 20.
In here, in this run, this streak away from Wang. Some pause here for the second seed. He's just not used to this.
9-3.
This is someone here this weekend who, with Fan Zhendong upset, with Hugo Calderano not playing here, has got the chance to go out overall in the WTT Series titles lead. He's won the biggest prizes. He's used to winning, but he's in a real match here in this semi-final, and he knows it.
9-4.
These are the moments where you can get carried away and where you have to remind yourself, I mean, you do it all times, but especially in these moments, of the line. What is too aggressive and what is too safe? How do I balance on that line?
6-let.
Will be a let.
5-9.
kind of on to make a lot of ground. He so, was so keen to come round and take it there, Lynn. Another one gone, though. It's four. Back. The one from here. Training by three now.
Left. 6-9. Nine,
the gap is narrowing here. It's becoming all the more tense in the Infinity Arena, particularly for Lynn Munro. 9-2, back to 9-7. But back with the service.
Six
of the last 8 points for the Chinese.
A joke. Coming into that one, had such a transition to make in a regular one, and he's made a winner in the corner on the run against a spraying Wang Chuqin attack. I mean, what is this?
What a way to bring up game points.
And one needed.
He's starring game under the lights.
Love one.
Game six here of a possible seven is utterly gripping, absorbing, compelling. Opening men's semi-final of this WTT Champions Frankfurt. Wang Chuqin, the former world number one. Let's remember, he's on a win streak as well. 18 match wins in a row. It's all under threat because of an inspired effort, this, from the silent assassin, Lynn Munro, who we've known for a long time can trouble the best. But on this big stage, he is threatening to make the biggest statement of all.
This is the level that he brought at the Olympic Games, where he nearly beat Fan Zhendong in that unbelievable semi-final match. He's had some tough losses, Lynn Munro, but he's learning from them.
Three, love.
And so far, the shot selection has been pinpoint, precise, and mature. A timeout.
Yeah, I'm not surprised.
Love.
It was Wang Hao who called the timeout. As much as Wang Chuqin, what we could pick up from their chat, Wang Hao was just trying to calm him, just said, just stay there. And simple, stay in the moment. His head's got to be in an absolute spin with what he's seen go Lick. Past him here.
Love. Four.
Thing he said, Wang Hao, was to serve to his forehand because his backhand, we all know it's so strong. Wang not heeding it there, and he paid for it.
Right into the middle, took it so early there, Lynn Munro, using that pace, can't let the ball disappear closer towards the body. Unbelievable counter. That is, honestly, I've got no words for that. No words for this performance.
Thanks, love.
He's threatening to dust him up now as well in this this sixth game, Lynn. I mean, how often can you say that? And a shake of the head from Wang. He's peerless in the WTT series. On this win streak, he's gone tied with Timo Boll, fifth all-time on active streaks. Is the streak going to get snapped here?
Seven,
Max is on that somewhat. 4 points away now, the silent assassin, from making all the noise.
This feels like how Ma Long has felt against Wang Chuqin.
Love.
It's on the other foot now. Wang is just having to suck all this up at the moment. The quality of his opponent here on the Infinity Arena. It's the thing with world table tennis. No one is untouchable. No one is unbeatable. The depth in this sport right now That is a joy to behold. And Lim Win Roo here, stepping up on the big stage, is set to shock one of the very best.
Line one.
A point back. It's all for the moment for one.
This is just unbelievable. Unbelievable. Wang Qiuqin is about to get silkily, seamlessly and silently assassinated here.
Two, 10.
8 match points left. This is going to make a wave in the world of table tennis. More than a splash.
Lin
Win Roo breaks new ground here in Frankfurt.